Hey YouTube, Tech Intimidation. Today we're talking about emailing large files. So, number one, if you have Gmail, you can send attachments that are up to 25 megabytes in size. So that's quite a bit of space. I mean, the old limit used to be 5 megabytes for most email systems. Gmail upped the ante to 25 megabytes. But you still have a problem on the other side. What if the other person receiving your email cannot receive more than 5 megabytes or can't receive up to 25 megabytes? They still will not, your email will just get rejected. So we need another workaround to send large files. Two options. The first one is Google Drive. So if you have a Gmail account, you have a Drive account. And you can upload files into your Drive account, which was just recently expanded. Now your file space can be up to 15 gigs. You have up to 15 gigs of space. And so what I did was I uploaded this video, which is huge. Over here you can see, if I get the info, same file. It's 1.23 gigs, so it's way too big for an email. So I put it in Drive. So now I have that file in my Drive account. And if I mouse over the attachment button, I have an insert files using Drive button. If I click that, I can either add files here if I just drag and drop, or I can select from files that are already in my Drive account. And what that does is it inserts a link. So now it's not actually inserting the file into the email, it's just adding a link, and only the person that you send this to has access to that file. So it's not publicly available, it's only the person that you email it to. So that's option number one. Option number two is to use Dropbox. So I have another video on three ways to share and collaborate with Dropbox, and that outlines the different ways to do that. If you have Dropbox already installed, you would just open your Dropbox folder, go to your public folder, or just drop it anywhere in your Dropbox, copy your file into there. It's already in there for me, just to save time. And you would just right click or control click if you're on a Mac and say copy public link, go back to your email, and paste it in, and then they would be able to download the video from that link. And this link with Dropbox is publicly available to anyone. They don't have to have a Dropbox account. They can forward that link to anyone, and anyone with that link will be able to download it. And that is how you can email large files. So if you have any questions or comments, just leave them below. Also subscribe for more videos from Tech Intimidation.